two type of rotor, one is saline pole rotor and non-saline pole rotor. Saline pole rotor means projected pole. So here you can see that is the poles are projected in nature. So like this, projected type. So non-saline means smooth cylindrical. So next slide you can see. So here this is the saline pole rotor. This is non-saline pole rotor. In saline pole rotor, this armature, this is air gap. This portion is air gap, and this is rotor, four pole rotor, NS, NS, alternating pole, NS, NS. Okay. So here this is saline pole rotor. In saline pole rotor, the air gap is not uniform, whereas non-saline pole, the air gap is uniform. This is the difference. We have two type of rotor. One is saline pole rotor, and another one is non-saline pole rotor. Then which one is best? Here the poles are projected. If you rotate with high speed, what will happen? This produces more noise because here air gap less. So in that air, the rotor has to rotate. That means it produces more noise. Whereas in non-saline, we have the noiseless operation. Saline rotor, the diameter of the rotor will be more. The diameter of the rotor more means the entire machine diameter also more. So here the diameter of the rotor is less. This is the robust construction. Non-saline is the robust construction. Saline is not robust construction. So next slide you can see the this thing. This is another one view, saline pole rotor and non-saline pole rotor. So this is practical saline pole rotor, 10 pole saline pole rotor you can see. Then this is the comparison between saline pole rotor and non-saline pole rotor. Saline pole rotor means poles are projected, here non-projected. Air gap is not uniform here. Air gap is not uniform. Here uniform, air gap is uniform. Then here diameter is high and axial length is small. Here diameter is small diameter, large axial length. Here mechanically weak, here mechanically robust, because the axial length is more. So axial length is more. So axial length is more. So mechanically weak. If you rotate high speed, there is a chance for damage. So mechanically weak. So mechanically weak. Here mechanically robust. So normally this is suitable for low speed application. So mechanically weak, so suitable for low speed application. Here this is non-saline, is suitable for high speed application. So low speed application means normally the water turbine and IC engines are the suitable prime movers. Then steam turbine and electric motors are suitable prime movers for the non-saline pole rotor. Then here damper windings are required. In case of saline pole rotor, here not necessary.